All right, it is Financial Literacy Month, a great reminder to check on your financial situation and clean up your money management habits. Couldn't we all benefit from that? Joining me this morning to talk about it, financial advisor Maggie Jandro. Maggie, good to see you.
Good to see you.
And quickly, I can't welcome you back. Your brand new mom, Matilda, how's she doing?
She's doing great, thank you.
Oh my gosh, congratulations. We're so excited for you. But you're back on the couch, we're talking money. Let's talk building blocks for financial literacy. What should we be thinking about?
Sure, there's five pillars. How much you earn, your debt repayment, your budget, your credit score, and saving and investing.
All right. And I love to budget. For other people, it's like this massive headache that feels overwhelming. What are your best tips on that front when it comes to actually budgeting?
Sure. I love to hear that you love to budget because you're right. Most people find that overwhelming. So we try to simplify it by sticking with the 50-30-20 rule. 50% of your monthly income should be going towards your needs, such as your housing, your food, your insurance, your health insurance. 30% should go to your wants, such as vacations and dinners out. And 20% should go to savings and investing. And I suggest you automate those savings so you're paying yourself first the moment your paycheck hits your account.
Headlines this week, some college students will pay $100,000 a year to go to college. Mm-hmm. So many of them saddled with debt. Others have it from other things. Mm-hmm. How do we tackle that? What are we thinking about on that front?
Sure. So we usually have two methods, the avalanche method and the snowball method. They both rely on the fact that you're making minimum payments to all of your debt, because that's going to positively impact your credit score. But any additional payments you're making with the avalanche method, you're going to make to the highest costing interest first. And then with the snowball one, it's to your lowest amount that you owe. With the avalanche method, you're going to pay less in interest over time. With the snowball method, though, it's really a psychological exercise, because if you could pay down your small debts first and kind of tackle them, you have motivation to keep paying down your debts.
You mentioned credit score there briefly. I get the text message from my bank once a month that my report is in. For folks who are trying to change the dynamic and see that number go up, what would you suggest?
Yeah, there's a few factors that go into credit score, but most important is your payments and when you make them. So make sure that you're making all of your payments on time. Again, automate those payments so you don't have to worry about them being late. Other important factors are repaying your debt so that when your debt goes down, your credit score should increase. And lastly, your length of credit history. So if you do finally pay down your debt, don't close those accounts because you want a long credit history. That will help your credit score. Instead, cut up your credit card. Don't use it once you've paid it down, but don't close the account.
We talk a lot about preparing for retirement and knowing that that number looks different for everybody. General ballpark feelings as to kind of what we're thinking about on that front?
Sure. There's a ton of online tools that are free that you can use for your own situation. Certainly speak to an advisor as well for something customized. But a rule of thumb is the rule of 25. So let's say that you know you need $50,000 a year withdrawing from your 401k in retirement. If you multiply that number by 25, you get $1,250,000. That's probably how much you need for a healthy retirement savings so you don't run out of your money.
When we talk about financial literacy at large, I think that some people might shy away from making moves because it feels overwhelming or they don't feel like they're smart enough to grasp it. Thoughts on kind of where to start if you're watching us this morning, you'd be like, this is a lot to take in.
Absolutely. So here in Connecticut, I used to be a volunteer for the Connecticut Money School. They offer free workshops on these five pillars of financial literacy, from credit score to debt. And so if you just go in and Google Connecticut Money School, you'll be able to see all of those workshops on their website. And they're free. And there's even some in Spanish for those that are Spanish speaking. So that's a great first place to start. Also, there's free online resources such as Farnoosh Torabi's So Money podcast. She's wonderful and makes everything really digestible. And you can also follow us on also social media platforms at Jandro Wealth. We post daily financial literacy tips as well.
All right. As always, some really fantastic information. Next time, baby Matilda on this couch.
Oh, perfect. She'll make her debut.
All right. Good morning, Matilda and Grandma watching at home. Thanks for being here.
Thank you so much.